Gajananam Bhutaganati Sevitam Kapitta Jambu Palasara Pakshitam Umasutam Soka Vinashakaranam Namami Vigneshwara Pada Pankajam Gurur Brahma Gurur Vishnu Gurur Devo Maheshwara Guru Sakshat Parabrahma Tasmai Sri Gurave Namaha Sadashiva Samarambam Sankaracharya Madhyamam Asmat Acharya Parjantam Vande Guru Paramparam. Welcome to Sri Rudram Lesson 10, Anuvagam 6. As usual, we will have a quick review of last Anuvakam and then proceed to the lesson today. What did we learn in last lesson? Some of you missed it because of Memorial Weekend, but we conducted the class, some attended. We practiced the Ganapati Dhyana Sloka, which we do every time. And we learned Anuvakam 5 of Namakam with all the intonations and the meanings, and we completed Anuvakam 5. In fact, one of the students later on recited to me, and he checked the intonations. So anyone is welcome to practice it with me in case time permitting. You can call me later on the phone. You can recite it and check whether the intonations are okay. So having said that, what are our goals today? Today again we start with Ganapati Dhyana Slogam as usual. And we're going to start with Anuvagam 6 and learn meanings of keywords. And we'll try to complete Anuvagam 6 and 7 if possible, time permitting. I want to combine this because Anuvagam 7 is a short one, and maybe we can combine it together to save some time. Okay, we'll start now with the Dhyana Slogam. Om Gananantva Ganapatikum Havamake Kavim Kavinam Upmastavasamam Jetarajam Brahmanam Brahmanaspata Anasrinvan Odivisi Dasadanam Om Mahaganadipata Jenabaham. Anuvagam 6. I'll recite it quickly and then we'll go with the meanings. Namo jeshtaya cha kanishtaya cha nama purvajaya cha parajaya cha namo madhyamaya cha pagalpaya cha namo jaganyaya cha buddhiyaya cha nama sobhyaya cha pratisabhyaya cha namo yamyaya cha chemyaya cha nama urvaryaya cha kalyaya cha nama slokyaya cha vasvanyaya cha namo vanyaya cha kakshaya cha nama shruvaya cha pratishravaya cha nama asushenaya cha asuradaya cha nama shuraya cha vabindate cha namo Varmine cha varudine cha namo bilvine cha kavachine cha nama srutaya cha srutasenaya cha. So this Anuvagam has 15 lines, 2 suktams. And as I said before, it is again describing Rudra in different forms. The variety is something amazing. Namo Jeshtaya cha. The Namo, the first Namo, has got an extended Dirgha Swarga. It is Namo Jeshtaya cha Kanishtaya cha. Jeshtaya cha means the eldest, the senior most. So it is very apt that he is the senior most. And he also represents Ganapati, who is the Jeshta, his eldest son. Kanishtaya cha, Kanishta means younger. And everything he created later on, he is in all those things which was born later. So he is also among the younger ones, Kanishtaya cha. He is also in Subramanyam, who is the younger son. The next line says, Nama Purvajaya cha. Now, Purvajaya is something relating to the cause of creation. Began with Hiranyagarbha, as you know. And it ends eventually with Kalagni. So, Purvajaya represents the Karana or the cause, the start of everything, the very first one. Cha Aparajaya cha. Aparaja. Aparaja is born later on. So, it's virtually everything that was created later on, the effect of Purvajaya, the effect of creation, the effect of the karma, the cause. So it represents cause and effect, Purvajaya cha Aparajaya cha. Next line is a Namo Madhyabaya cha Apakalpaya cha. Madhyabaya, Madhyam means middle. One who appears in the middle. There is a beginning and there is an end. And you have a middle too. And he appears in the middle too. It is a status, sthiti. You may ask, well, he says, you will say Ganapati and you also say Subramanyam, which is Jaishtayaja Kanishtayaja. Who is Madhyamayaja? You know, Shiva has a Madhyamasana also. Who is he? He is Ayyappan. Ayyappan in Shabarimalai, it's also his son, who is Madhyama. Madhyamaya cha, between creation and end, which refers to all the living beings which were created and who are existing right now, and they are being maintained by him. It is include the celestials and devas who are existing. They are all in the middle. So, Namo Madhyamaya cha, all those existing in the middle, cha Apakalpaya cha. Apakalpa means one who is immature, child, young. So he also is present in the immature people. Apagalpaya cha. Namo Jaganyaya cha Budhniyaya cha. Namo Jaganyaya cha Budhniyaya cha. The Jagat. Jagat means the world. Jaganyaya means the things which exist, which includes wild animals, worldly animals, birds, trees, everything. All that the world has. Budhniyaya cha. You know, Buddha, Buddh is the root there in Sanskrit. Means actually, Buddha got his enlightenment. Buddhi. But this Buddhi, Budhni, refers to born out of roots. Born out of roots. Referring to plants and trees. So Jaganyaya cha refers to all living beings, but particularly trees and plants. Cha Budhniyaya cha. The fifth line. Namasobhyaya cha Pratisaryaya cha. Namasobhyaya cha Pratisaryaya cha. What is Sobhyaya cha? You know, the world has Papa and Punya both. Manushya Lokam has got Papa and Subhya, Punya, that is called Sobhya. He is a lord of the world which has both good and bad. Papa and Punya, and that such a lokam is called Sobhya. Pratisaryaya cha. Pratisarya. Pratisara means mobile. That which moves. The moving world. all that moves, vehicles, animals, worms, everything that moves, prati saryaya cha. So he exists in everything that is mobile. Going further, namo yamyaya cha chemyaya cha. Yamyaya refers to the loga of Yama, Yama logam. Yama is the god of death, as you all know. He is also Dharma Raja. He is the person who determines what a soul should undergo depending on the good or bad it has done. So he also exists in the Yama Loka. Yam Yaya Cha, Chem Yaya Cha, Chemam. Chemam means safety, welfare. So he is also the person who is providing the welfare or well-being, providing chemam to everybody. Chem Yaya Cha, it's a quality, providing the welfare, taking care of the welfare of people. Chem Yaya Cha, Nama Urvaryaya Cha Kalyaya Cha, Urvaryaya Cha. Urvarya means that which has emanated from earth. Uru means to grow. Urvaryaya Cha, all that grow from earth, including the grass, the little plant, the herbs, everything that grows from earth. Nama Urvaryaya Cha Kalyaya Cha. Kalyaya Cha refers to the field where you grow corns, you grow wheat, you grow rice, all the grains that you grow. In Tamil they call this kalam, or the agricultural land where the farmers plow and grow grains. That cultivatable land is called Kalyaya Cha. So he exists in that cultivable land also. Kalyaya Cha. Namaslokyaya Cha Avasanyaya Cha. Namaslokyaya Cha Avasanyaya Cha. Shlokya, the word slokam comes from there. The Lord of the Vedas. From the slokam, one who is described in the Vedas. He exists in the Vedas, in the slokams. Avasanyaya Cha. Avasanyaya Cha means the end of Vedas, referring Vedantam, as you know, Vedantam. He exists in the primary Vedas, and he also exists in the Vedanta. Cha Avasanyaya Cha. Going further, Nabo. Vanyaya cha kachyaya cha. Nabo vanyaya cha kachyaya cha. Vanya, vanam. Vanam means forest. Vanyaya cha kachyaya cha. The produce of the forest is called vanyaya. All the things that come from the forest. You have so many spices, so many herbs, roots, everything that comes from the vanam. He exists in those also. Vanyaya cha kachyaya cha. Kachya means bushes in the form of clusters, cactus, shrubs, which even go in deserts. Bushes. So that is kachya. So he exists in those forms too. Namo vanyaya cha kachyaya cha. Namashruvaya cha pratishravaya cha. Namashravaya cha pratishravaya cha. Shrava comes from the reverb root shru. Shru means to hear. Vedas are called Shruti, as you know. Shruti is what is heard, comes from Shru. Here it is Shravaya. Nama Shravaya cha. He exists in the form of sound. Shrava means sound. In the form of sound, Shravanam, as you know, this is about Shravanam. What is heard? He exists in the form of sound. Shravaya cha pratishravaya cha. Pratishrava means echo. When you talk, you get echo. You get a reflection of your sound. So he exists in the reflection of sound also as echo, or what is called pratidvani. You know, when you recite mantras, it is said that he also echoes those mantras. So if you ask, seek blessings, you get it in the form of blessing as a pratidvani. So that's why mantras are told in public in loud noise, loud voice, so that you get the echo as a sort of blessing. So it exists in sound as well as echo. Namashravayata pratishravayata. With that, the first para or the first part of this Anuvakam, the Suktam, ends here. Then we start with the second para. Nama asushenaya chasurataya cha. Nama asushenaya chasurataya cha. Asu means quick, swift, very fast. Shenaya here refers to the army. No, asu is a very common term. In Bengal they use word like Asutosh. Asutosh Mukherjee, Asutosh Banerjee. The first name will be Asutosh. Asutosh. Tosh means one gets happy. Asutosh means one who gets happy very quickly. Referring to Lord Shiva, that he gets very, very happy very quickly. Even if you recite the two words of Shiva, he gets happy. Even if you do a small archana, he gets happy. Very quickly. There are other devatas where it takes a much longer time to please them. But here, Rudra gets pleased very quickly, so becomes Asutosh. But here, Asushenaya refers to swiftly moving armies. Shiva Ganas, they move very quickly, and Shiva is the driver. He exists in the form of quickly moving armies. Chasuradaya cha. Chasuradaya cha. Asuradaya cha. Quickly moving chariots. Fast moving chariots. He rushes to protect his devotees. And the ratha is the vehicle that moves, and when it is fast moving, it's able to reach the devotees much faster. So here he is described as one who is existing in fast moving armies and fast moving vehicles. Going further, namashuraya chava bindate cha. Namashuraya chava bindate cha. Shura means valiant, brave. Because he has to be brave to be able to fight others and be able to win over others. Therefore, he exists in the form of brave people, fearless. Cha avabindate cha. The cha which you get is and, as I mentioned earlier. Cha avabindate cha. That is a split up. Here it's given in sandhi form. Cha avabindate cha is one word. Actually, they are two different words. Cha avabindate cha. Avabindate cha is one. Avabinda means to shatter, to destroy. He shatters the enemies. Shiva is one whose rakshana's duty is rakshana, to protect, at the same time also to sikshana, which is to punish. And he is a quick punisher and he shatters his enemies. So he has that personality of one who moves swiftly to protect devotees, at the same time swiftly to attack enemies. And he is existing in the form of a brave person. And he also has the ability to shatter his enemies. Chava bindate cha dabo varbine cha varudine cha. Varmine. Varmine, he has to also protect himself. So varmine is the protective armor. So that when people attack him, you have to wear a protective clothing. Varmine. So that is applicable today in everywhere. You see people who, even the cops have their own protection. The people who are working on the roadside, they have their own protection. So everybody has to have some protection against potential forms of attack or potential form of something harming you. So he also has a armor, protective armor. Varmine cha varudine cha. Varudine cha vritam. It comes from the root vritam. Vritam means a seat. Varudine cha. Now he has got secret places where he sits in the chariot. You know, you take an armored tank when it moves, you don't see the driver because he sits in a secret place and he is protected throughout. Because the driver is attacked, the tank cannot do anything. Therefore, there is a seat provided for the driver which is inside the tank, which is a secret place. Nobody can see it. Unlike a car where you can see a driver, but in war, you cannot see the driver of a tank. So here, he is seated in secret places. In that secret place, in human beings, is really the heart. Nobody can see. Only you can feel it, that he is in your heart. So, varudine cha, he has secret places of sitting or taking his abode. Nabo varbine cha varudine cha. Going further. Nabo bilmine cha kavachine cha. Nabo bilmine cha kavachine cha. Now bilmine means wearing a helmet or headgear. That's also a protective gear. So you have people wearing helmets when they ride a motorcycle. Even though it is not compulsory for car drivers, but for motorcycle drivers, it is mandatory that they wear a helmet. Because if they fall down, they should not get hurt on the head. So he also exists as one who wears a helmet. Kavachinecha, protective gear including your ankles, your arms, whatever, your eyes, these are all protective. And that is kavachi nature, exists also in the form of protective gear. He protects you, that's the reason why we have protective gear. To safeguard you from harm. And he exists in those kind of protection also. Namo bilmine cha kavachine cha. Namasrutaya cha srutasenaya cha. Namasrutaya cha srutasenaya cha. Now here, srutaya means one who is famous, one who is heard everywhere. People hear of famous people, ordinary people are not heard. Srutayacha means one who is very famous, who is heard everywhere, one who is revealed by the Sruti. So he is that famous person, Srutayacha. That famous Rudra. Srutasenayacha. One who is also the head of a very famous army, which is the Shivaganas. Srutasenaya cha. He exists also in the form of Shivaganas. And that army of Shivaganas is also equally famous. So with that, we end the Anuvakam 6. Now we have some time, so what I will do is, I will take up the next lesson 2, which is Anuvakam 7. But let me pull out the slide. I got the slide now. I'm going to share the screen. Yeah, I think you'll be all able to see the lesson 11, which was intended to be a separate lesson, but I'm combining today. We have some time. So we will skip the first 2 slides, go on to the slokam straight away. Now this Anuvakam 7 has got 9 lines, so it's a short one really. It's again made up of 2 paras, 2 suktas. So we will start with the very first line. Namo dundubhyaya chahanyaya cha. Dundubhi is an instrument, you know, it's like a air instrument. It's a Mangalavadyam, Dundubhi. So it exists in the Dundubhi Vadyam. Chahanyaya cha. Chahananyaya cha. Chahananyaya cha. Hananya is the stick that they use for beating the drums, you know. The one which makes noise on the drum. In Mridangam or Tavil or Berigai, which is a big drum, they use big sticks, you know, to beat it with. So exists in Dundubhi, the musical instrument, and he also exists in those sticks which are used for beating the drum. Namo Dundubhyaha, Namo Dundubhyaya cha Hananyaya cha. The next line. Nabo drishtaveca pramurusai. Nabo drishtaveca pramuruchaya cha. Nabo drishtaveca pramuruchaya cha. Drishtave is referring to those people who are valiant. You know, when you go into the army and there is a war going on, there are some people who get scared and run back. It happens. But there are some who do not mind facing the bullets or arrows which confront them. They would still go further. They are not scared. They are fearless. They are valiant. Even if they get hurt, they get killed, they don't mind it. So such people are very rare. Suras, Paramasuras as they call it. So Drishtave refers to those people who are most valiant, do not turn their back when there is a threat to their life. You know, people get scared even with small difficulties. But when a life itself is in danger, there are people who still face it without really turning their back. And such people have almost lion's heart, as they call it. Very valiant, brilliant. Paramasuras So he exists in such people. So in other words, we should develop those qualities. So Drishnave refers to such people. Brahmo Ruchaya cha Prabhu Ruchaya. Actually it should be not B, I think it is P. There is a mistake here. This is should be P. Pram Ruchaya cha. Pram Ruchaya cha means one who plans, who designs, who analyzes various things, strengths and weaknesses before he ultimately makes a decision. A good planner, a good manager, who is able to scheme out things. Such a person is referred to by the name Pram Ruchaya cha. Just imagine you take a human body, it is so beautifully designed. There must be, everything has got a designer, right? You build a house, there is somebody who is an architect who designs it. You take a car, somebody has designed it. You take a table, you take anything for that matter, there is somebody who plans it, who designs it, puts it on a drawing board and somebody makes it. Who is the designer of a human body? Now, it will be amazing if you look at the system. Just imagine your nose is here, your eyes are here. What if your eyes were on the top? What if your nose was on the top? What if you had only a single route for inlet and outlet? You know, these are things. It is amazing that the human body is designed so beautifully to work and to do many things. Such a designer, brilliant designer, is Pram Ruchaya cha. So he is described as this kind of a person who is a super planner. He is the Srishti Karta, as they call it, Srishti Karta, the father of creation, the father of designer, father who plans things and schemes. Such a person is described as Pram Ruchaya cha. So namo drishtave cha pramushaya cha. Going further, namo dutaya cha prahitaya cha. Namo dutaya cha prahitaya cha. Duta, you probably know it, one who is a messenger, an ambassador, who carries a message from one country to another. Now, Duta is a very delicate kind of job, not easy. Today I was doing the Parayanam of Sundarakandam and Hanuman is a Duta. He is a messenger to convey the message to Ravana that look, you better release Sita, otherwise you are going to have trouble. For that, he should first know that Sita is there in Sri Lanka. So he enters Lanka in the night to be unseen after overcoming all kinds of challenges on the way. But after having entered, he is unable to find Sita. At one point, he gets frustrated. In fact, he thinks of killing himself. But then he realizes that is not the solution. The solution is to continue his effort and enthusiastically hope for success. And he does eventually find Sita, but he is not sure how to convey to Sita that he is there. So these are challenges being faced by a Dutan. After having seen her, after having conversed with her, he creates an opportunity to meet Ravana and conveys a message. Now all this happens in less than 24 hours and he has to scheme out, and the planning process itself is described in Sundarakandam. one of the most beautiful pieces of Sanskrit literature authored by Valmiki. So such a critical part of Duta. Even Krishna was a Duta. He carried the message from Pandavas to the Duryodhana, saying that you give us 5 countries, if not 5 cities, if not 5 villages, if not even 5 houses. And this message had to be conveyed very delicately. You don't expect Duryodhana to offer a mighty seat for Krishna as a Duta, nor do you expect Ravana to give a mighty seat to Hanuman. So they have to be humble, they have to be really have the ability to convey the message in a subtle way and get the response. So it's a very dangerous task. And you have to virtually beg someone for a favor to in order to achieve the ultimate objective. Like Hanuman is telling in a very humble manner, even though he is bound to Ravana, that what he is doing is adharmam and he should change and seek the pardon of Rama. Likewise, Krishna is also conveying to Duryodhana that what they are doing is not right and they should give away. He should give away at least 5 small pieces of land. He starts negotiating. Although the negotiations fail ultimately, and Duryodhana says, I won't even give even 5 needle points of land. That was his answer. But the task was very delicate. So you have this kind of a Duta's task, and such a Duta, Shiva comes. Shiva himself has been a Duta. There are many stories, but we don't have time to talk about it. Sundaramurti Nayanar was one of the 63 devotees of Shiva, and he asked Shiva to be a Duta to go to his wife, because Sundaramurti Nayanar married another girl and he was not allowed to come home to his wife, locked the door, and he told Shiva, please go on my behalf and tell my wife, please open the door. So that is the story of Sundaramurti Nayanar, who was a friend to Lord Shiva. So Dutaya cha Prahitaya cha. Prahita is one who is interested in the subject, a king who is interested in the welfare of his subjects. One who is always doing things for the benefit of citizens and who is just. Prahitaya cha. Nabo nishangine che shruti mate cha. Nabo nishangine cha ishruti mate cha. Nishangine. Nishangine means the sword that he keeps in his hand, the scabbard. And ishruti mate, we have talked about it before, which is the place where the arrows are kept. The quiver on the shoulders, it's kept in the shoulder like a golf club case. So he exists in the form of the sword in his hand. Nishanginecha ishudimatecha namastishneshave chayudinecha namastishneshave chayudinecha namastishneshave. Now, Tishteshave is very sharp arrows, sharp. Cha Ayudhine Cha. Actually, it is, when you pronounce it, you go Cha Ayudhine Cha. But actually, Cha Ayudhine Cha. That's how the split up comes. Ayudhine. Ayudham, of course, you know that it is weapons. In all weapons. Cha Ayudhine Cha. Namas Swayudayacha Sudanvanecha. Swayudayacha Sudanvanecha. Swayudayata is the best weapons are beautiful weapons. Sudanbane cha. Su refers to something beautiful. So it's a beautiful bow. Danbane cha. Sudanbane cha. Namasrutyaya cha patyaya cha. Srutyaya cha patyaya cha. Srut. Srut is, you know, in villages, there are no roads, so people walk one behind another. There is a small path. It's called one person path. Vehicles can't go, but they people walk on that. It's a walkway, usually for one person. It becomes a path because people keep on walking on it. Srutyaya cha, such a person walks on it is a srutyaya. So he exists in rural people, one who walk on a single path. The path here is also philosophically meaning the path of karma. You have many songs which talk about it, the path, a single path of karma, which is narrow, and one person walks alone. You don't take a group with it, but in your own swakarma, and you walk alone in a path in order to reach your goal. Such a karma path. In Tyagaraja Kirtan, you got one Kirtan, no? Chakani Raja Margamulunteka. You might have heard this song. Tyagaraja refers to the Margam. So it's a Margam of one single path. So he exists in such a path, one-minded path. Patyaya cha. Path means road. Like you have Janpath, Rajpath in Delhi, right? You got path. So Patyaya cha refers to those who travel on road, not necessarily a single path, but a multi-lane road where you have many vehicles going, and he travels. City dwellers, basically city dwellers, those who reside in cities, exist in rural people as well as the city dwellers. Srutyaya cha patyaya cha namakatyaya cha nipyaya cha. Now he refers to various forms of water, water sources in which he exists. So katyaya is small streams, rivulets, streams of water which you usually find in forests. Nipyayacha is those which waterfalls, water falling from a mountain. It exists in that kind of water source too. You'll find further description of water sources here. Navasudhyayacha sarasyayacha. Sudhyayacha refers to marshy water, marshy land. Cha sarasyaya cha. Saras means kind of a lake, a big pond. In Pune we have a pond like this, which is itself called Saras Bagh. It's called Saras Bagh. You know, lotus is called sarasya. Sarasya. Sarasu is the name we will find. Sarasu means referring to lotus. Born from a pond, from the lake. So here he exists in the form of those ponds or lakes. Sarasyaya cha nabo nadyaya cha vaisantaya cha. Nabo nadyaya cha vaisantaya cha. Nadya, nadi, comes from word nadi. Nadi you all know, it's river water. Vaisantaya cha. Vaisantaya cha, you know, village you have this small a pond where people wash the animals. It's a very small one, may not be very clean, but that is called Vaisantaya cha. Vaisantaya cha. So exist in those kind of small ponds too. Nama kupyaya cha vatyaya cha. Kupa. Kupam, you know that. Kupam is well. We have the drinking water coming from the well, right? most villages have wells. So exists in those well waters too. Cha vatyaya cha. Vatya means spring, you know. You have these hot springs and you have many ways where you get spring water. You go Costco or Sam's Club, you get spring water. This is water coming from underneath the ground as a fountain. So it exists in that kind of source too. So namo vatyaya cha, cha vatyaya cha. No, the point here is about water. Now water is a holy thing for us. In every ritual, we use water and we worship water as one of the principal five elements. So water exists in its natural form and it has several sources. From whichever source it comes, water is supposed to be holy. And because it is one of the five elements, we worship it. It is created by nature. You don't make it artificially. You can say, all right, I'll combine two atoms of hydrogen and one atom of oxygen and I can create water. But where do you get hydrogen and oxygen from? They are not created by you. So if you look at it, it is a creation of someone who is almighty, who is the ultimate. So water is described as a Rudra here. Namo Varshaya cha Varshaya cha. Namo Varshaya cha Avarshaya cha. That's how it is. Cha Avarshaya cha. Varshaya cha. Varshaya means what? It is coming as rainwater. Varshana. Rain water. Avarshaya cha is absence of rain. What it means? Sunshine. The absence of rain produces also many plants, cactus, deserts, some worms, some bacteria, some germs also are produced because of lack of water. Cha avarshaya cha exists in rainwater, also those which are produced by lack of water, rainwater. Going further. Namo meghyaya cha vidyutyaya cha. Meghyaya. Megham means cloud. Meghyaya cha exists in the clouds. Vidyutyaya cha. Vidyut means lightning. So you have in India, the electricity boards, many of them are called Vidyut Nigam. Electricity companies. Vidyut Nigam. Vidyut is actually a term of lightning which is used for electricity now, because lightning itself is a form of electricity. So it exists in the form of lightning, the form of clouds. Meghyaya cha vidyutyaya cha idriyaya chatapyaya cha. Idri is referring to seasons. Who produces the seasons? You have now, you have summer. Nobody has artificially created summer. It has come naturally as a part of natural environment. You have winter, you have autumn, you have fall, Vasanta Ruto, when all the things start blossoming. It's a beautiful season. Who creates them? He is a creator who is called Idriyaya cha. The person who creates all the seasons, the Rutus. Chatapyaya cha. Chatapyaya cha. Actually, it should be read as cha ataptaya cha. In English transliteration it is given correctly, but when you pronounce it together, you go fast. Cha tapyaya cha, you say it is actually cha atapyaya cha. Atapya. Atapya is also the products of sun. The products which are like light, like energy, like heat, these are all products of energy. So without them, you cannot exist. Therefore, the Rudra exists in all these elements which are produced by nature in the form of light, energy and heat. Ātaptyāya cha. Namo vātyāya cha reshpiyāya cha. Vatyaya cha reshpiyaya cha. Vatam. Vatam means referring to the air. In India, you have these air conditioned coaches, you get Vata Anukula. Vata Anukula, it means the air is very comfortable to you, air conditioned. Vata. So it is referring to the air. It exists in the form of air. Reshmi ayacha. Reshmi is the hail that comes after rain. Sometimes you have hail here in Chicago. It comes like small white stones, you know, like ice. That is called Reshmi. Reshmi ayacha. Namo vastavyayacha vastupayacha. Namo vastavyaya vastupayacha. Vastu means home. Vastavyaya vastupayacha. Actually, vastu means object. Vastu means a place where you reside. That is why you have this vastu shastram, you know, home. When you design a home, what direction it should face, where should be the kitchen and all that is vastu shastram. Vastu refers to the home and he exists in homes. Vastavyayacha, vastupayacha. Vastupaya refers to the vastu purusha. You have vastu purusha. The person or the deity which lives in the home, whoever it is, he exists in that form also. You may have a Ganesha or you may have a Dattatreya, you may have Hanuman, whoever is the home deity, Vastu Purusha, he exists in that form also. So with that we conclude the Anuvagam 6 and 7. So to quickly summarize it, I will recite it together. Namo jeshthaya cha kanishthaya cha namo purvajaya cha parajaya cha namo madhyamaya cha apakalpaya cha namo jaganyaya cha buddhiyaya cha namo sobhyaya cha pratisarjaya cha namo yamyaya cha chemyaya cha namo urvaryaya cha kalyaya cha namo slokyaya cha vasanyaya cha namo yanvanyaya cha kakshyaya cha namo shruvaya cha Pratishavaya chanamo asushenaya chasuradaya chanamo shuraya chava bindate chanamo varbine cha varudine chanamo bilbine cha kavachine chanamo srutaya cha srutasenaya cha. Guidance Anuvagam 6, Anuvagam 7. Namo dundubhyaya chahanyaya chanamo drishtavye cha pramarasaya chanamo dutaya cha prahitaya chanamo Nishangine, Cheshudima, Chanama, Tishnesha, Chayudine, Chanama, Swayudai, Sudan Venetianamo, Sutia, Japatia, Chanamakatia, Chanipia, Chanamasutia, Sarasia, Chanamo, Nadia, Chavaisam Titanamo, Kupia, Javatia, Chanamo, Vashini, Vashai, Chanamo, Vashai, Chanamo, Megia, Chavitia, Chanamitia, Chatapia, Chanamo, Vatia, Chereshmia, Chanamo, Vastavia, Chavastupa, So totally 15 plus 9, 24 lines. So try to practice it and we will go to lesson 12 next week. So now I'm going to unmute you all and if you have any question, you can raise your hand. And